Algebra 1. In this video, we're going to talk a little bit about the basics of a quadratic function. Now, the word quadratic should be familiar to you because we learned about that when we were learning about how to name polynomials. And if you remember, anything that was a second degree polynomial was considered a quadratic. And so now we're going to talk about that equation, which we kind of learned about with polynomials, and then we're going to talk about what the graph is. Remember, this is a function. That means for every input, there is exactly one output. So here's some basics. A quadratic function, okay, your equation can be as simple as y equals ax squared. That would, you know, the example I have is y equals x squared. That would be a monomial, so one term, but I'm still taking it to the second power. The more general one you're going to see, kind of like your slope-intercept form, this is your standard form, y equals ax squared plus bx plus c. A, b, and c are just numbers, as you can see from my example below. Okay, y equals 2x squared plus 7x plus 8. A would be 2, b would be 7, and c would be 8. And those would just be the numbers that are a, b, and c. In my first example of y equals x squared, a is 1, and I don't have a b or c. Those terms aren't there, which can definitely happen. Okay, so that's just a generic what the equations are going to look like. It is a second degree, which means we will never see an exponent bigger than a 2. And we will always have a second degree. We'll always have an exponent of 2 there. Okay, and nothing bigger. And then the graph of a quadratic is called a parabola. And this is what a parabola looks like. It is a U-shaped graph. Okay, it looks just like this. This would be a sketch of what y equals x squared looks like, or maybe y equals 2x squared. This would be that y equals ax squared, okay? Now, parabolas don't have to be that kind of a U. It could be, an upside down U. So that is a parabola as well. I'm not sure what the equation of that thing is, but it would definitely have this form of y equals ax squared plus bx plus c. The y equals ax squared is going to keep you around that 0, 0 mark. You're going to be there, okay? But by adding more numbers like bx and c, that's going to move the parabola around on the graph and where you're going to end up with something like this. So parabolas can be anywhere. They can, this is what we call open up, of the up u, and then this is open down, the upside down u. So that's what parabolas, they're always going to be u-shaped. They will never, 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 will it be sideways? It'll either be an open up or what we call an open down parabola. And these are kind of the generic equations. Similar to how you had lines that were y equal mx plus b. If m was positive, you had a line going up. If m was negative, you had a line going down, but it was always a line, okay? Now, we're gonna get a little bit more specific. And what I'm gonna do is we're gonna focus on just that y equal ax squared here for this video. So, if you have the equation y equals ax squared, and a is greater than 0. What I mean by that is a is a positive number. So you have y equal x squared, because that would be a positive 1. Y equals 2x squared, y equals 3x squared, y equals 5 halves x squared, y equals 3.8 x squared. If a is a positive number, here are 5 characteristics we're going to know about that graph just by looking at the equation. Well, the first one is the obvious. It's what I already told you. Because I can see that it is a second degree, it's a quadratic, I know the graph is going to be a parabola. It's going to be a U-shaped graph, all right? Now, because A is positive, if you remember from before, I said that the graph could open up or down, A being positive tells me immediately that my parabola will open up, okay? That means I'm going to have that U, all right? Now, this bottom part of the graph here, this is called the vertex of my graph, okay? The vertex is that point when my graph switches directions. Because this graph has a U shape, right here my numbers are going down, 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 down. I reach the very bottom, or minimum, and then my Y values start going up. Okay, so that vertex is the point where you will switch from your y values going down, getting less, to your y values going up. here's a vertex on this graph. In this case, my y values are going up. They're getting higher, higher, higher. They reach their highest point, and then they start going down. So in this case, my vertex is a maximum because the switch is from down up to down. So because my parabola opens up, that means my vertex is always going to be the very, very bottom of the graph because I have a u, and the bottom of the u is, well, that's the bottom. That tells me that my vertex is going to be a minimum amount. It's going to be the very minimum of the graph. This is the lowest y value my graph has. If you notice, there's nothing below it, okay? That vertex is at 0, 0. It's at the coordinate point 0, 0 at the origin. And then the line or axis of symmetry, both terms are used, line of symmetry, axis of symmetry, that is the y-axis. So there is symmetry here because if I cut a u in half, if I could draw correctly, you would see that it's exactly the same on both sides. So we do have a line of symmetry, and that is important with quadratics. It's the y-axis, which is also the equation x equals 0. A line of symmetry for any parabola will always be a vertical line. And if you remember, our equations for vertical lines are always x equals a number. Okay? And in this case, it would be x equals 0. And so that's what we know. That's what I know about this graph just by seeing that. I know the vertex is at 0, 0 because it does not move away from 0, 0 until I start adding this b, x, and c, until I start adding numbers. The adding of the numbers is what moves that graph around. If I'm not adding anything, I just have ax squared, then I know my parabola is going to stick right there at 0, 0. The vertex is going to be 0, 0. Okay? Next, y equals ax squared, but this time, we're going to say what happens if a is less than 0. In other words, a is a negative number. Well, number 1 will be the same. It's still going to be a parabola because it's still a quadratic. We still have a second degree. But instead of having my parabola open up, the negative is what is going to make this parabola open down, which means that instead of that regular u, I'm going to have an upside down u like that. And now my vertex is no longer the very bottom of the graph. My vertex is now the very top of the graph, which means my vertex is now the maximum. Now, if you notice, it's still at the coordinate point 0, 0. That didn't change. All this was is basically taking the open up graph and flipping it upside down, so now it opens down. So that vertex is still at the coordinate point 0, 0, and the line of symmetry is the same. It's still cutting it in half, the y-axis, our x equals 0. Okay, and so those are the basics that we know about a parabola just by looking at the equation. So if I'm not adding anything, there's no bx or c, it's going to stay at 0, 0. Okay, it's going to have a vertex, and the line of symmetry will be the y-axis. The only difference is, will my graph open up? A is positive, or will it open down? A is negative. So you guys can get on Desmos and play around with that. You could definitely get on there and graph a y equals 3x squared and then try y equals negative 3x squared and just kind of look at the differences there when you graph a bunch of them, and you'll see more of what I'm talking about.